Hey gang, James here with That Halloween Bro. And I thought I'd take you on a journey through making our Heart in a Box Valentine project here. I found this box at Goodwill for a couple of bucks, and I brought it home and I thought, what a cool concept to try and put a heart in a box. So that's what I did. So I started by removing the backing here, which was really actually super simple because it's kind of similar to like a picture frame. And then you've got the spoon and this fork here that I took off with mighty strength here. I don't know why I'm struggling there. It was super brittle, so it was eventually really relatively easy to get off at some point. There we go. Good job. I also debated keeping that back canvas on there because it was super dingy and white, but I decided not to because this fork and the spoon left a lot of remnants behind. So I decided just to kind of remove the canvas and try something different. So I started with this fabric, which you might remember from when I did the Tim Burton party a couple years ago. I didn't like it because the stripes were too fat, so it didn't really kind of give a good look. What I did find was this dish towel. I know, a dish towel. And I cut it up. I really liked the design on the fabric, and so this is what I wanted to use because I felt like it would really kind of stand out with the heart. So once I cut it out to size, it was then time to glue. And as you can see, for whatever reason, I have glue strands everywhere. So that's a fun special effect, isn't it? All right. So gluing the fabric down, I probably went a little extra with it. I really wanted to make sure there was a firm hold on the back of this because we're going to be attaching the heart and there is some weight to that. I didn't want the fabric to come off. And as you can see, I just kind of threw the fabric on there for a second there. All right, but now I've got it on there, getting it all smoothed out. I want to make sure I smooth out the hot glue, which kind of burns your fingers too, but you don't want lumps or those weird, like, textured bits, I guess, that hot glue can leave behind. So really try to smooth everything out. All right, the next is the box. And if you're like me, man, do you hate price tags from thrift stores. They are so hard to get off. Yeah, I know. So I realized I had to spray paint this because I wanted it to give it that blackish, obvious color to it. And I couldn't remove the glass. So I took some painter's tape, put some on both the inside and the outside, and used an X-Acto knife to cut off the sides there. So what you don't see on camera is I spray painted it outside and then it's drying. So I took the heart here that I have just laying around, like everyone does, I guess. I did add some extra red paint and varnish to the heart because I wanted it to still give it that bloody wet look that most people find attractive in a heart. All right, so I wanted to lay it out to make sure I knew exactly what I wanted to do with it, but I realized that I wanted to do something extra than just put this heart. So I found a dead rose and a branch and some moss, and there's a hole at the top of this heart. So what I did was I stuck them both in there to see kind of how they looked. I actually really liked the aesthetic. It kind of was, it added a little bit of something extra, some more macabre, you know, to it. So that's what I did. So taking my trusty hot glue gun there, went ahead and glued everything in. You know, the trick with dead flowers too is they're very brittle, so you have to be super careful with them, so you couldn't handle it too much, but man, does it add a really cool effect, honestly, more than buying like the fake flowers. So if you ever get flowers or flowers are on sale, buy them and like let them die and keep on hold on to them. They really add a cool effect, I think. So realizing that the branch kind of blends in a little bit with the fabric, I definitely added some moss to kind of help accentuate the branch a little bit. Far away, you're not going to really notice it too much, but up close, it looks really good. All right, so now is time to attach said heart to the backing. And again, using my trusty hot glue gun here, I wanted to make sure there's enough glue to really make sure it stands out. That glue is piping hot from the steam. Steam? Is it steam? That's steam. And then so I went ahead and fixed it to the back, making sure it had a firm hold. After it was dry here, I actually took it and went around the edges to, again, just to increase like the stability of it, make sure that it, you know, we're not going to eventually find it falling off inside. Not that we couldn't fix it, but... All right, so now that I've got the box back inside from spray painting, you want to make sure it's completely dry. Even if you have to leave it over for an hour, be patient, because what we do next is going to require it to be on a dry surface. And what we're going to do is we're going to add this medium crackle that you can get at Michael's. I love this because it does the distressing and the paint cracking for you, really. I mean, it really gives it a nice distressed look. And if you've seen some of my other projects, you've seen that I've used this before. All right, so get a paintbrush that you don't mind throwing away, because there's no point in cleaning these brushes after this because it's really goopy. But you want something that's going to give you some really good coverage too. And you want a good thick layer, thick with three C's, of this medium crackle all over it. The lighter you use it, the lighter the distress will be. The more you use it, obviously, the more distress you get out of it. So it's really kind of up to you how much distress you want. I want to go full distress look on this. So full coverage. Look at my camera skills. I'm hitting the camera. Can't really see it. But you get the idea. You want to make sure you get some really good full coverage on all of it. Same here, you want to make sure that good coverage on the front and the sides is important. It's just going to give it that really consistent look, as long, you know, knowing that you've given it a full coverage spread of this medium crackle. All right, and you want to let that fully dry as well, and that may take some time. Don't rush it, because if you do, the effect is going to be, it's not going to look as good. All right, so then you want to paint. I'm using an acrylic. It's unbleached titanium. I got the paint from Michael's. I'll link it in the description as well. I like this color because it's a really off-white, so it's really kind of that fun macabre. It really stands up nicely against the black. So working usually in one direction, back and forth, and working pretty fast, you're going to start to see the distress look happen pretty quickly. And so you don't want to paint too much over once the distress look starts to happen, because you'll start to lose a little bit of it. So once I got all of this covered, take another look at it, because you may find spaces that you missed, but definitely keep an eye on it. And this is what you're going to get from that final product once it starts to dry and the crackle effect starts to take a... All right. And now I'm going to take the painter's tape off with it. And if you're like me, removing painter's tape is super satisfying. I don't know why. And hopefully... yours always comes off way easier than mine does. All right, once we remove the painter's tape, it's going to be time to put this box back together and see the final result. But before you see the final result, I just want to thank you for watching and remind you to stay pretty and Halloween on. ¶¶